What you will see in this video is the design of a basic comparator in 180 nanometer CMOS technology, how to choose the right W-L ratios for each transistor, the delicate trade-off between power consumption and a slew rate. You'll dive into simulation setup and finally witness the real performance of the circuit in action. So buckle up, you don't want to miss this one. And this is the schematic that I've designed for this comparator. I've used an ideal current source for the bias of this circuit. The reason I used ideal current source is avoid designing a band gap reference, because designing a band gap reference can be topic of another video. In this video, we just want to design a comparator. Then I placed NMOS transistor next to the ideal current source. This NMOS transistor is used in current mirror configuration to pass its current to the differential pair. And this is my differential pair. In fact, this is an NMOS differential pairs, because inputs are gates of NMOS transistors, and PMOS transistors are used as loads for this configuration, and they are used in current mirror configuration to make sure the current in both sides are almost the same. The M7 transistor is an NMOS transistor and responsible for the tail current of the differential pair. There is 40 microamps current related to ideal current source, and this current is flowing through M6 transistor, and this current is mirrored into this transistor, which is responsible for tail current of the differential pair. And this is the output stage of our comparator. I've used PMOS common source amplifier for this reason, with NMOS active load, which is M8, and this M8 transistor is responsible for pulling down our output whenever the input voltage is lower than the reference voltage. I've also created a symbol for this schematic of comparator that I've designed for simulation purposes. And I set the reference voltage to 500 millivolts, so the input voltage will be compared with these 500 millivolts. And I've connected the VA in, which is input voltage, to a sinusoidal voltage source. The magnitude of the amplitude of this sinusoidal voltage is 1 volt, and its frequency is 1 kilohertz. And the circuit that you can see at the left of the schematic is responsible for providing the VDD and VSS of the simulation. I also performed transient analysis for the circuit. And here is the result of the analysis. As you can see, our input voltage is a sinusoidal voltage, which you can see with yellow color. Whenever this voltage crosses 500 millivolts, or half of a volt, and its magnitude is higher than this value, the output of our comparator is logical one, as you can see the red wave form. And when the sinusoidal voltage magnitude is lower than 500 millivolts, or half of a volt, the output of our comparator is logical low, or zero. And you can see our comparator works fine in this experimental simulation and with these specific values. In order to design a comparator in Cadence software, first you need to launch it. Then you are faced with such window. You need to navigate to Tools, Library Manager. Then this window will be showed to you. By selecting File, New Library, I created a new library and I called it Pipeline ADC. And then by selecting File, New Cell View, I created a cell and I called it Comparator. Then I was faced with a window like this, and it is attached to TSMC 180 nanometer technology. By using a TSMC library and PDK, I was able to use these transistors with predefined specifications. First, you need to place an ideal current source, and by pressing Q, by selecting components and then pressing Q, you go to properties window of objects. This ideal current source exists in analog library and its name is IDC, and you can change the name of the instance if interested. I set the DC current of this ideal current source to 40 microamperes. This current source is responsible for the slew rate of your system, and if you want to increase the slew rate, you need to increase the current of this source. But when you do this, you need to consider that you are sacrificing power efficiency, but you are reaching a higher slew rate. In order to place instances in your schematic, you need to press I. And by pressing I, you can search the libraries like analog library and find objects or TSMC 180 nanometers technology to place, for example, NMOS transistor. But you need to place symbols. And as you can see, now you can place the instances in your schematic. The length of M6 transistor is set to 500 nanometers and its width is set to 5 micrometers. It is the same for M7 transistor. As you can see, its width is equal to width of M6 and their length is 500 nanometers. It is the same for both of them. So the current that flows through this transistor is exactly mirrored into transistor because their W to L ratios are exactly the same. And if they were different, for example, if W to L ratio of M7 transistor was double of M6 transistor, then the current flowing through this transistor would be 2 times more than this current that exists here. And now we are going to discuss the most important parts of our schematic, which are these transistor. Because we are using this configuration as a comparator, we need to set the W to L ratio of our input transistors so high they are responsible for the accuracy and speed of your comparator. So you need to set the W to L ratio of this transistor so much higher than the other transistors. As you can see, I've set the width of these transistors to 40 micrometers and their length is not 500 nanometers anymore, and I've set it to 180 nanometers, and I have used the maximum capacity of the technology for this purpose. And for the gates of these transistors, I've created pins. You can do that by navigating to Create and then Pin. You can set names for your pins and select the direction, whether it is input, output, etc. And then your schematic can be connected to other components in its symbol, which we will see in minutes. And M3 and M4, which are our loads and are in mirror configuration, and their width is set to 5 micrometers and their length is set to nanometers. And if you wanted to increase the accuracy and speed of your comparator, you need to increase the W2L ratio of these two transistors. And here is my output stage. I've set the width of this transistor to 6 micrometers and its length to 500 nanometers. If you perform transient analysis and you saw that your logical one is not close to your VDD, which for this technology is 1.8 volts, and if, for example, your logical one was 1.5 volts, you need to increase the width of this transistor. By increasing its width, your logical one would have a higher value and closer to VDD. And this M8 transistor is responsible for pulling down the output of our comparator when our input voltage is lower than our reference voltage. And as you can see, this transistor, because its gate is connected to a node here which always have a positive value, it is always on and it pulls down the circuit. But whenever our input reference value is higher than this one, so it works as if it is cut off, and this transistor is on, and the voltage of this node would be connected to VSS because it is always on, and it works as it is fully on. So the node here is connected to VSS via this pass, so the voltage here would be close to VSS. If the voltage here is zero, then our PMOS transistor would be turned on, so it works as a short circuit and the voltage here would be on. And because this transistor is stronger than this transistor because of its width, it is 6 micrometers, it's only 1 micrometers, when both of them are on, this transistor is stronger and the voltage here would be drawn towards our VDD. And this is how the simple comparator works. And whenever our input voltage is lower than our reference voltage, then it works as if it is cut off. So if this transistor works in a way it is cut off, it seems that here is open circuit and this transistor is always on, so the voltage of this node would be close to VDD. And if here is logical one, so this transistor is off and it's not working, so by this transistor the voltage of this node would be close to our VSS, and our output would be a logical zero. This is the fundamental working structure of our comparator. After finishing the schematic and placing pins for my schematics, I saved it, and by heading to create cell view from cell view, I was able to create a symbol for this schematic. And you can see it here that I've created this symbol here. By using these lines and shapes, you can create your own schematic symbol and place pins in this manner. And by selecting create selection box, you can create these red lines here. And let me show you how to create cell from cell view. You can choose the library that you want to save your symbol, select a name for it, and etc. After I created a symbol for it, I went to Cadence Library Manager and I created another cell and I called it Comparator Sim, which stands for simulation. And in this window, which is comparator sim, I placed my symbol. Then I wanted to create VDD and VSS for my circuit, so I placed a VDC and I set its DC voltage to 1.8 volts, which is the VDD for 180 nanometers technology. And then I created another DC voltage with 0 voltage, and then I connected to this GND, which exists in analog library and its name is GND. That's because I didn't want to connect my voltage source directly to GND, which is a global net name. So I placed VSS here, and by wiring I connected the VDD and VSS of my circuit to VDD and VSS of my simulation schematic. By pressing W you could do the wiring, and by pressing L you can set the net names to connect, for example, this wire to this wire without wiring them directly to each other. Then I set the reference voltage to 500 millivolts, so our input voltage will be compared to 500 millivolts. If our input voltage crosses 500 millivolts and is bigger than this value, our output would be a logical 1, which is 1.8, which is the value of our VDD. And if our input voltage is lower than 500 millivolts, our output would be logical 0, which is a value close to VSS, something around microamperes. And I set our input voltage to a sinusoidal voltage source, and its name is VCN, and it exists in analog library. And I set its AC magnitude to 1 volt, and I set the frequency to 1 kilohertz. And something that I forgot to tell you, all these transistors exist in TSMC library, both NMOS and PMOS transistors. I placed pins here for the simulation purposes. So by placing these pins here, the name of these nets would be V in and V out in the simulation, which we will see in seconds. And then by navigating to launch and selecting analog design environment, I was faced with this window and I wanted to perform a transient simulation. To do that, by selecting this choose analysis button, I select transient analysis and I set the stop time to 5 milliseconds, and the accuracy I set it to moderate, and I ran the analysis. Then I head to results, direct plot, and waveform. I selected these two knots, and the waveforms were drawn for me. As you can see, these yellow sine wave is our input, and whenever it crosses 500 millivolts or half of a volt, our output, which is this red waveform, is logical 1, and its value is 1.79, which is so close to our VDD and acceptable. And whenever the value of our input is lower than 500 millivolts, our output is logical 0. In this video, we explored how to design a basic comparator, a building block that can be used in future mixed signal projects like analog to digital converters. If you found this content useful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more electronics videos. Good luck!